Well, these are paintings more or less from the last 10 years. I called the exhibition Since 2000. And each room deals with a specific chronology starting around 2003 and 2004, going up to 2013. The first two rooms contain paintings I painted in about 2003, 2004. On each wall there's a pair of paintings, and in these paintings I took a composition and turned it on its side. So in each case you see both the original composition and the one that has been turned side by side. In the first big room, I wanted to exhibit what I call my more abstract paintings. And on one wall, there are three paintings that are each a grid of prisons, the prisons all gathered together. I feel have a kind of pessimistic or threatening quality. And on the other walls are three paintings dealing with the prisons as elongated, almost abstract shapes that I place side by side that almost have a musical feeling. The next room has four paintings that are all have a vertical motif that I think of as almost having a looming, ominous quality. And then the next room has four paintings, all with the same composition. And throughout my career, I've been interested in painting and repainting the same composition several times using different kinds of color. And the most recent room has four large paintings, each with a black background. And that's a kind of exploration of modular composition, because in each position you can either have a prism or a cell, or one rectangle, or it can be broken up into two squares. And on the last wall, there are paintings from 2013 that are smaller and experiment more obviously with notions about architecture and architectural form. My paintings have always been about the relationship between abstract art and architectural reality. Right from the start, I wanted to take the idea of the square or the rectangle as it exists in abstract painting of the 20th century and connect it to architectural form and the environment we live in. The three elements of the paintings, the cells, which are rectangles, pure closed rectangles, the prisms, which are the rectangles with the horizontal or vertical bars, and the connections between the cells and prisms, which are these bands of color that I call conduits. And my work over the last 30 years is really about how these two kinds of shapes, the prisms and the conduits, are connected on the flat surface of the canvas. All of the paintings have a second panel on the bottom. And the way I think of each painting is as an architectural section. So you're looking at the prism or cell from the side. The two canvases represent ground line, the difference between what you see above the ground and below the ground. And I wanted to use a physical division between two canvases to represent that. Beginning in 1980, there was a lot of interest in French writers. A little later, Foucault and Jean Baudrillard. Especially Foucault was fascinated with the relationship between space and power. So in fact, that had a lot to say about art, because the guys over there said space was a pure thing that could be investigated without relationship to power or to its use. But Foucault was constantly talking about, beginning with the prism, but other things as well, how the way we think about space is based on is a result of how power is organized. And that's what I got interested in around 1980. I began to make paintings where the primary form was a square with lines on it, which I called a prison. And I began to think about a second form, another square without lines, which was a cell. And all of my work is a kind of obsession about how these prisons and cells are connected by means of these diagrammatic lines, which I call, I began to call conduits. In the 2000s, the aughts, I painted a bunch of paintings like this in which each canvas was a prison and they were put together as a grid. And I thought of these paintings as claustrophobic or somehow a little bit disturbing. You know, it might be hard to think about them this way. The 2000s, in English we don't really have a word for it yet, but 2005, 2006, it was a really disturbing period in America with George Bush and the terrible war in Iraq. And, you know, you could really think of life at that time. I really was distracted by these things all the time. It was like, in a way, the worst possible outcome of what American politics could be like. And at the time, I began to paint these claustrophobic prisons, almost thinking of prisons stuck against prisons, stuck against prisons, thinking about that situation. When I was a young artist, people mostly thought of abstract geometric painting as a kind of hermetic activity. Minimal art or minimalist abstract painting as something that had no reference in the outside world. And to me, all this work had a very direct connection with the kind of space we live in the 21st century, the way we're connected by highways and by the internet and all forms of electronic communication. And in a way, what my work was about right from the beginning was how do we represent that kind of space that we live in abstract painting. It's really an extraordinary experience to have my exhibition here at this time with the museum's collection of American color field and minimalist work. In fact, going through that collection is almost like looking at all the things that influenced me when I was a young artist. Kenneth Noland or Frank Stella and the work of Robert Morris or Donald Judd. And when I began to make my work, those were all the kinds of art that I was looking at the time.